I might show it up there.
Yeah.
May the risen Christ fill our hearts with faith and courage as we embrace our calling to be disciples of the living God. Let us proclaim the good news of God's love and light to all creation.
And may the resistance of God's love transform the world.
Let us pray. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Amen. Good morning. Throughout the service today, you're going to see this refrain, and I'm going to say, Christ is risen, and you will say,
Christ is risen indeed.
Christ is risen.
Welcome,
welcome to this time, this place, this space of worship. Welcome to each and every one of us who have heard God's call for us to join together in community this day to celebrate the risen Christ, to celebrate our faith together. This is our time, this is our place, this is our space of worship. We belong here, we are welcome here together. And as we gather to share in this time of worship, let us pause to remember that we worship on lands that are by law, the unceded lands of Mi'kmaq, the ancestral territory of the Mi'kmaq people. May we live with respect on this land and live in peace and friendship with its people. And as we celebrate the risen Christ, we say, Christ is risen. Our announcements have been printed. They have been sent through email and all different means, and let's go through some of them. We've joined together this morning for worship. Tuesday, the Marian Unit is going to meet at the home of Maureen Roddick. On Tuesday and Wednesday, there's quilters in the parlor. On Tuesday evening, we're going to be setting up for the community luncheon, and on Wednesday, the community luncheon is going to take place. If you would like to help set up or prepare on Tuesday evening or prepare and clean up on Wednesday, please sign up in the narthex. There is a sheet there for volunteering. On Wednesday evening, we have junior choir practice. All are welcome to join the junior choir. You're going to hear the junior choir sing later on in the service, and they are spectacular. If you have youth younger than 18 who would like to join in with the choir, they're more than welcome. The next practice, like I said, is this Wednesday at 6 p.m. here. We're coming through the front door. Thursday is youth group. So that is youth ages 12 and up that happens upstairs on Thursdays from 3:30 to 5. We have amazing youth leadership who are guiding our youth and creating a great space for them. It's fun, there's snacks, there's games. I encourage all youth to join with them. For youth group, you come to the side door for 3:30. It's 3:30 to 5 on Thursday. On Thursday evening, there's a stewardship committee meeting. I'm on this Saturday. It's bowling. Yay. It's our bowling tournament. Everybody's welcome to join. Today's the last day that you can sign up, though. So sign up in the narthex. And if you're not here present and you want to sign up today, you can email Wendy. Her email is in the bulletin that was sent out. So if you would like to join in with the bowling, please let us know. It's going to be fun. I love it. And it's anybody. You don't have to know how to bowl. It's super fun. They put bumpers up for you, and then they don't go in the ditches. I don't know. Or what they're called.
Gutters.
Gutters, thank you. Yes. Stephanie's going to be making the lineup, so make sure you let Wendy know. Please and thank you. By the latest Thursday, I guess. So we'll try to do it today. Looking ahead, there's advance notices there for meetings and so forth coming up, but I want to draw your attention to the pie sale. Our pie sale is going to take place on April 13th. Pies are being sold, and you can sign up to buy a pie or to help make pies or both, and that is also in the narthex. The Easter sunrise service. Thank you so much to everybody who got up early this morning and got a little cold because it was a little chilly this morning, and help us celebrate the resurrection of Jesus at our sunrise service. Special thanks to the Chanel family for our delicious breakfast, which was enjoyed by all in attendance. We had about 20 people there this morning. It was a great group, and we did. We celebrated Christ is risen. Oh, I caught you off guard.
Oh,
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
I'll try to get it up on the spot when you're good. So you got to pay attention all day today, right? The Youth at Region. Youth from grades 6 to 12 are invited to attend Youth at Region from May 9th to 12th in Toro. And it's a great opportunity to come together with youth from all over our region and celebrate our faith and have a lot of fun. If you're interested in joining in with the youth, or if you know some youth who might be interested in joining, just let me know, and I can make arrangements to get them signed up. So it's grades 6 to 12, and let me know before the deadline for sure. And I know for sure that we have three for sure that are going right now. So it's going to be a great group going. And Emma actually is going to be one of the leaders there. So Emma will be one of the youth leaders there. So you get to hang out with Emma, which I think is a great time. So donations to the Memorial Fund have been received in loving memory of Dorothy Cameron and Donnie Palmer by Jean Hale. And a gift to the outreach program has been given in loving memory of parents Raymond and Helen Hale, brother Raymond, grandparents Joseph and Charlotte Hale, and family by Jane Ralph. We have saved the date on the back of the bulletin there. Our auction and dessert evening will take place on Wednesday, May 29th, so mark that in your calendars, and there's more information there. Our Karma Closet support has been amazing. We have a lot of stuff, and we're going to celebrate that next week. So if you come back next week, we'll have decorated, and we'll be celebrating all of the wonderful goods that we'll be sharing with Karma Closet. The Agape Supper was on Thursday. Thank you to everybody who came and attended. We had a wonderful potluck meal, sharing fellowship with one another. Thanks for everybody that brought yummy food. Everything was delicious. And thank you to all those who helped clean up. Many hands made light work, and we were done in record time. So that was wonderful. The bowling information, the counters. We are welcoming to our community of faith later on in the service, through confirmation, Victoria McGrow, Keely Brooker, Alexander Dooley, and Luke Marchand. And we are excited to welcome them later in the service. We have a webpage. I'll be sending it out, the link to that, in the email next week, so you can go check it out, or you can search for it on Google, or it's attached to our Google Maps, it's on the Facebook, there's lots of different places to find it. On this page, there's lots of information and so forth, but I want you to notice that we have our events calendar is on the page as well. So it will have in it things like the bowling tournament that's coming up, and when things are taking place here, when people are in the office. So if you're trying to remember a date or what's happening, you can always check the events calendar on our webpage. It is Easter Sunday, and our sanctuary has been beautifully decorated by our UCW. It is beautifully decorated in loving memory of those that we hold near and dear to our hearts, that we remember on this special day. So let's take a moment to pause and remember those that we have taken an opportunity to remember today. And we begin with remembering Ted Kelly, parents Jack and Doc Inglis, Ralph and Rhonda Kelly. We remember Chuck Roddick and Jeff McDonald. Remember Andrew and Laura Johnson, Lois and Philip. We remember loved ones and parents Bernie and Beatrice McNeil. Remember our friend Gerald Muir. Remember family members and Donnie Palmer. Remember Rob Canning, Dorothy and Ted Boyd, Ruth, Chet, and David Canning. Remember Russell Canning and parents Raymond and Rosalind, Auden and Catherine. Remember loved ones and Betty Mosier, Viola and Harry Steele, Chuck Roddick and Gabriel Chislett, Jim and Marie Doyle. Remember Reggie Chabasol, Lillian and Stanley Cook, Beatrice and Cyril Connors. Remember husband Alan and daughter Kathy McDonald. Father Alan and sister Kathy McDonald. Remember loved ones. Remember Doc and Arnold Williams. Remember mother Jean McKenzie. Dan and Gail Stewart. Remember Gerald Muir. Errol Holt. Marion Holt and Harry McKay. Remember Helen Feuer. I meant to check this. Anyone know?
Zaretta,
thank you so much. We remember Helen Zaretta. Remember Doc, Al, Karen, June, Linda, and Linda Frazier. Remember Harvey Stewart, Isabel, and Bob Stewart. Remember Isabel, Steve, John, Ron, Raymond, and Raymond Wright. Remember Stephen and Isabel Wright, Raymond and Ronnie Wright, Mary and Clem Sutherland, Rosalind Shaw McLeod, Raymond McLeod. Remember Hugh McLeod,
John Muse, Donald and Betty Burns, parents Ronald, Sadie, and Sadie, brother Ronnie Kennedy, and son Todd, sister Wanda, parents Roy and Marion Stewart. Oh God, we remember all of these today. We remember their presence. We remember their legacy that they have given to us. We remember them on this day, the day that we celebrate the risen Christ, and we celebrate the hope in you that all will be reunited in your presence again. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Is there anything else coming before the committee at this time? If not, Hubba?
Arnold Angel?
The old fellow.
Someone said the old fellow. I wouldn't say that.
Where are you?
Can't see you.
Oh, there you are. Hi. It's your birthday today.
Happy birthday. And Janice, your birthday was last week?
Yes.
Very quietly, yes. Who told you? Someone behind me. So happy birthday, Arnold and Janice. Let's sing. Anyone else? God of resurrection and new beginnings, as we gather in this sacred space, we feel your presence among us, breathing new life into our weary souls. We come together as a community of faith, eager to celebrate the risen Christ and to embrace the transformative power of discipleship. May our worship today be a testament to your unwavering love and the hope that springs eternally. Amen. Our mission and service story today, over the past few months, we have shared stories centered on traditional and non-traditional education. Mission and service recognizes the profound connection between the resurrection story and the transformative power of education. This Easter, we pause to think of great sacrifices and miracles. Just as Jesus emerged from the tomb, defeating death and showing us that we can be raised to new life, education opens the mind, dispels ignorance, and fosters a deeper understanding of Christ's teaching and compassion. Mission and service, in its commitment to education, seeks to empower each partner to be a beacon of knowledge and compassion in the world. With your support, we engage in mutual learning, seeking opportunities to grow our understanding of the world through the eyes of our partners. Thank you for empowering mission and service partners in all forms of education. Blessings on Easter. Our offering has been gathered. It has been brought together in all the various different ways in which we continue to support and sustain the important ministries that we offer here from St. Paul United. And for that, we give thanks. Let us now join together in the presentation of our offering.
Oh God, we bring before you our time, our talent, and our treasure. We bring this to you as all is yours. We bring it in celebration of the risen Christ. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let us now join together in our prayer for wholeness and renewal. Let us pray. O God of resurrection, we come before you with hearts burdened by fear and anxiety. In the midst of uncertainty, help us to find peace in your promises and renewal. Grant us the courage to release our fears and embrace the abundant life that you offer to us through Jesus Christ. Heal our wounded spirits and fill us with the hope of resurrection, that we may walk confidently in the light of your love. Amen. Hear these words of assurance. We find assurance in God's abundant grace and boundless love. No fear, no doubt, no darkness can withstand the power of redeeming love. Let us embrace this truth and step boldly into the new life that God offers us. And we respond by saying, thanks be to God. Amen. We have an awesome special gift for us this morning. Our junior choir is going to sing for us Kaleidoscope.
Football, that's the best. On behalf of the congregation of St. Paul United Church, I present Luke Marchand, Victoria Boudreaux, Healy Brooker, and Alexander Dewey for initiation into the body of Christ through confirmation.
As part of the confirmation journey, we talk a lot about leadership. We talk about this being an initiative step, and the next step is offering leadership into the church. And they have been offering leadership all through their confirmation classes, and we've witnessed them throughout Lent, leading us at the beginning of worship, reading for us, offering musical leadership. They are a wonderful group. They're all part of the youth group. Alexander is one of our youth group leaders, and so we are very proud and pleased to welcome them this service to our church today as members of this congregation. I'm going to ask some questions that you're going to find familiar because they're part of our new creed. So. Confirmants. Do you believe in God who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit? If so, answer, I do by the grace of God. Desiring freedom of new life in Christ, do you seek to resist the evil of the world and live in love and justice? If so, answer, I will by being my helper. Will you proclaim Jesus crucified and risen in your words and in your actions? If so, answer, I will by being my helper. Will you join with your community of faith to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect and creation, and love and serve others? If so, answer, I will by being my helper.
I will by being my helper.
Congregation, Sunday school, please stand as you are
grace through confirmation. Do you, the congregation, and those gathered here at St. Paul United, encourage and affirm Luke, Victoria, Keely, and Alexandra as members of St. Paul United Church, working for the ministry and mission of Christ Church in the world? And if you do, answer, we do by the grace of God.
We do by the grace of God.
You may be seated. May the Holy Spirit, love's power, guide you, inspire you, and work with you all the days of your life. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, God's power, guide you, inspire you, and work with me all the days of your life. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, God's power, guide you, inspire you, and work with you all the days of your life. Amen. Alexander Dooley. May the Holy Spirit, love's power, guide you, inspire you, and work with you all the days of your life. Amen. It is in the household of faith that we welcome you with joy and thanksgiving. We are the members of the body of Christ. We are inheritors of God's promise. In the name of Christ, we welcome you. And all the people say, Amen. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Let us pray.
God. Your word is a light for our path. Let us listen for your word for us today. Amen. So the story continues. We began this story last Sunday, on Palm Sunday. We began it with parades of palm branches and shouts of Hosanna. We began it as the story told us that Jesus entered into Jerusalem down from Mount Olivet, and everybody was celebrating and everybody was excited. And we followed it through to the Passover meal on Thursday night. We had an agape meal where we remembered that Jesus gathered with his disciples, knowing that his time of rest was upon them. And he initiated this remembrance meal with them, the Last Supper, the same meal that we share at communion every year, every few months. And then there was the arrest, the trial, the punishment, the crucifixion. We remembered that on Friday. We told that story, and we remembered that story together. And then this morning, we read of how the women went to the tomb early on Sunday morning and found that it was empty. Let's share that story again, reading from Luke 24, verses 1 through 12. Early on Sunday morning, even before the sun had fully risen, these women made their way back to the tomb with spices and anointments that they had prepared. When they arrived, they found the stone was rolled away from the tomb's entrance. And when they looked inside, the body of the Lord Jesus was nowhere to be seen. Didn't know what to think. As they stood there in confusion, two men suddenly appeared standing beside them. These men seemed to glow with light. The women were so terrified that they fell to the ground face down. And the men said, "Why are you seeking the living one in the place of the dead? He's not here. He has risen from the dead. Don't you remember what he told you way back in Galilee? He told you that the Son of Man must be handed over. He must be crucified, and then on the third day, he must rise." Women did remember this. So they returned from the tomb and found the 11 to recount for them and the others with them everything that they had experienced. The Lord's emissaries, the disciples, heard their stories as fiction, as a lie. They didn't really believe any of it. Couldn't be possible. By the way, this group of women included Mary Magdalene, Joanne, Mary the mother of James, along with a number of others. Peter, however, got up and ran to the tomb. When he reached the opening, he bent down, looked inside, and saw the linen burial cloths lying there. The body was gone, and he walked away, full of wonder of what had happened. This is our gospel according to Luke. Thanks be to God. And today is just a day full of special treats, because now we have a special selection from our senior choir, Lord of the Dance. their traditions, they have a tradition of yelling out praise. They would say, Amen, Hallelujah. That's not the tradition we were raised in. And so, and the Protestant tradition we were raised in, the best that we can get at offering praise and thanksgiving would be clapping. So we should do it whenever we have the opportunity. So, thank you. Or you can say, Amen, Hallelujah, praise Jesus. I'm all for that. If you want to do that, actually, let's give it a try. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
Let us pray. O God, may the words of my mouth and meditations of our hearts be truly acceptable in your sight, our Lord and Redeemer. Amen. So today is the day that we come together to celebrate Easter Sunday. And we're filled with joy and anticipation. We're filled with hope. Today is a very special day. We've taken a journey to get here. We've journeyed through Palm Sunday and through Maundy Thursday, where we celebrated the Mandatum Novum, the new commandment that we are to love one another as Jesus loved us. And then on Good Friday, we came together and we heard the story of the arrest and the crucifixion, and our hearts left that time very heavy. And then we got together this morning, and this joy that we talked about, the women that would have found the tomb would have been confused as well, like very confused. This wasn't the norm. This wasn't supposed to happen. We know it's joy because we know the rest of the story, right? We've heard how Jesus appears. We've heard that this is the good news, that God's everlasting love continues and is risen among us forever. And on this special day, we're not only celebrating the resurrection of Jesus, but we're also, we have welcomed four new members to our congregation. Today is a day of hope, a renewal of new beginnings. This is why we have Easter in the spring, right? Because there's eggs, there's flowers that are blooming, there's all these images of hope and new life, and we receive new life in Christ. The story of resurrection is a powerful reminder of that hope and that promise. It's a story of triumph over death, over light, of light overcoming darkness, and of new life bursting forth. And as we look at this passage from Luke today, we see such amazing courage, and we see such amazing leadership from those women who first went to the tomb. They were so brave. They were so brave in the first place to go to the tomb. That was immense bravery. Because Jesus was a criminal in the law's eyes. He had been arrested and crucified a criminal's death. And they were looking for his accomplices. So where better to look for his accomplices than at the tomb? The women were so brave to go there, they risked their lives, they risked arrest, they risked, at the very least, getting beaten. But they went anyway, because they wanted to honor him. They went anyway, because they were called to go. They took the risk. They stood up, and they were leaders among the group. And even though they were afraid, probably terrified of what they found, they went and told the others this astonishing story. They didn't hide. They didn't go in hiding. They took this story forward. They shared this good news. And because they shared the good news, we continue to share it. So then we see Peter, right? Peter's in a room full of people who just heard this astonishing story, and everybody in the room's like, no, I don't think so. That does not sound right. And Peter goes, well, maybe I should check it out. Maybe I should learn a little more about this. Maybe I should go see for myself.
So he goes and he finds out it is the truth. What the women were saying is true. And then he remembers, like the rest of them, the promises that Jesus had made to them. The promise that he would rise again in 3 days, and his life is changed forever, and ours as a result. All these leaders in the early church were brave. They were willing to confront their doubts. They were willing to seek the reality of the truth, of the hope, of the good news. And they were a model for us all. And today, as we welcome our new members into our congregation, we're reminded of the importance of our leadership in discipleship. That as each of us follow Jesus, as each of us have been called here today to celebrate this Easter Sunday, we have been called to leadership. We've been called to be brave. We've been called to share the story of the good news of God's love in creation. Each of us is a leader in our own right. Each of us is called to boldly proclaim. Each of us is to live as witnesses of the transformative power of God's love. As I was saying to you, each of us is to model this good news in our everyday. Just as we say every week in our creed, we are called to be the church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect and creation, to love and serve others, to proclaim Jesus crucified and risen, our judge and our hope in life and death and life beyond death. God is with us. We are not alone. Every week we say this, and it is part of our calling as leadership. And just as the women and Peter were called to lead, just as Mary and Josephine and all of them were called, we too are called to lead in our communities, in our workplaces, in our homes. We're called to be beacons of hope, agents of change, ambassadors of Christ's love. So today, as we come together for Easter Sunday to welcome new members into our congregation, let us be inspired by the leadership and the courage of those who came before us and those who stand among us. Let us embrace our role as leaders in discipleship to boldly proclaim the good news of God's love to all the world, to boldly proclaim that Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
I told you you're going to have to pay more attention the whole time. I know, I lost you for a second. Let's bring it back. Christ is risen. Amen. This is the good news. This is the Easter hope. This is our proclamation as leaders, as models, as disciples in our community. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, on this Easter Sunday, we come before you with hearts full of gratitude and praise. We lift up our prayer for the world, knowing that you hear the cries of your people and respond with compassion and grace. And today we proclaim Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
For those who are experiencing darkness and despair, we pray for the light of your love to shine brightly in their lives. May they feel the warmth of your presence and find hope in the promise of resurrection. As we say, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
For those who are burdened by fear and uncertainty, we pray for courage and strength. Help them to trust your guiding hand and to walk boldly in the path of discipleship, knowing you are always with them. As we say, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
For those who are grieving the loss of loved ones, we pray for comfort and consolation. May they find peace in the promise of new life and assurance in your eternal presence. We say, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
For our community of faith, we pray for unity and fellowship. As we celebrate the risen Christ, may we be renewed in our commitment to love one another and share the good news of your salvation with all who we meet. And we say, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
For our world, torn apart by violence, injustice, and injustice, we pray for peace and reconciliation. Inspire us to be agents of change, working tirelessly to bring about your kingdom of justice and compassion. And we say, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Gracious God, hear our prayers. and guide us in the way of discipleship. May we follow the footsteps of Jesus, embodying your love and grace in all that we do. God of compassion and caring, we pray silently for those that we hold in our hearts this day. Source of all light, we praise you for the wisdom of your word and the hope of your promises. With all your saints on earth and in heaven, we commit ourselves to the dawning of your new age, and we pray together as we are taught, saying, Divine Creator, Holy Parent, our Mother and our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our closing hymn is Jesus Christ is Risen Today.